It's a beautiful Thursday morning because we are celebrating our diverse and rich heritage here in South Africa. And one way we know how to do that is through music, storytelling, and of course, ukutya. We love to eat. Right now, Uncle Tabzi is having so much fun out there with Chef Martin Bigimhlongo, and they're making delicious heritage food. Uncle Tabzi, nipheka ndongoko.
Thank you very much, Kuhle. I'll tell you one thing. You guys are missing out on all of the action here live in Johannesburg as we commemorate and celebrate Heritage Day. We're doing it through food. We celebrate the best way South Africans know how, and it's through a braai. Because Common's braai vandag, of course, it's all about remembering the importance of this day and not just forgetting the symbolism of this day simply because we've got fantastic feasts in front of our eyes. But of course, it's about recognizing that we are all so different and we're blessed and lucky to have a country that is so diverse and so rich in culture, and a day like this really has this really solid ability to bring us together in the most beautiful way, and we celebrate through food. And I can tell you now, wherever you go, doesn't matter where you are in the country, everywhere you go, you're going to be smelling some really awesome aromas of the different cultural dishes that the people out there have prepared. I can guarantee you that much. And it's a great time to share with everyone, share with your neighbors, make something really nice of your traditional food, and go knock at your neighbor's house and then offer them a piece of whatever it is that you have made. Of course, Biggie is still here, our spit master, turning the meat upside down and switching that up. But let's take a look at some of the comments that have come through. We've got Lerato Molefe, who's saying here, good morning Espresso Show and happy Heritage Day. I will be celebrating with my family and we'll cook some of our Sesotho traditional food and wear our attire a little later. We braai while doing the Jerusalem challenge and have fun. Beautiful. I love that. And then Jack Lepardi says, morning team, me and my family will just be celebrating at home, and my wife to be, she's going to be teaching me how to dance to Jerusalem. That's going to be an awesome day. Happy Heritage. Renee Summer says, good morning, I'm spending my Heritage Day with my family at my grandma's 100th birthday. Wow, that's a big one.
Wow.
That's a big one. Perfect timing as well. And then Mawila Betty says, good morning and happy Heritage Day to you. I'll be celebrating this day with my family wearing Xitsonga traditional attire and cooking some traditional food.
So what I have in front of you is El Palish la Mabele.
Okay.
That's how we call it in Siswati.
This here, that's
yes, this
pap.
Is a brown pap with Mabele pap, made with a nice chunky relish.
Okay.
This is a thick cut beef short rib with smoked qebeleza chimichurri. I made a sweet corn sakutash. That's why we were grilling our corn. Mm. This is qebeleza paprika chicken wings.
I love it.
And then I made kidneys and onions and some sweet potato flatbread.
So for those who don't know, like me, I mean, I don't know, what is qebeleza? Is this your secret sauce that you've made here, or what is it?
Qebeleza, it's a feeling. Qebeleza is, I think in America they'll call it umami, but qebeleza is that, you know, when you eat something,
yeah. By your ear, ringing at the end of your ear,
yes.
Just after you
everything nice.
Man, this looks so beautiful, and I love that, you know, you've got all the colors coming through here. It's a bit of a seven colors bride day edition, right?
I had to represent my mother. She said, of course,
otherwise you get into trouble. But of course, you were giving me some pointers earlier on how to bride the perfect ribs.
Yes.
What are those tips?
So short rib, I just went for a thicker cut because traditionally we go for the thinner ones.
Uh-huh.
So if you take your short rib, make your fire, put it, grill it a bit on the fire, and then be able to move it away from the fire, not directly, and then just get that indirect heat cooking on that.
Ooh,
but I chose
that.
A thicker cut of meat because, listen, I love my steak, and I love my meat from the bone, and this is the perfect combination.
You and I can certainly hang. In fact, I mean, obviously the taste is, or the proof is in the tasting. Anyone that knows me, Biggie, will tell you that I'm big on tasting. So should we try this?
Please, dig in.
Okay, let's see what this is about here. Ooh, Mabele, when last did I have that? That kick. It's hitting me. I absolutely love it. But of course, you can enjoy it with some bread as well. Mix it up, have some rice, have some pap, whatever it is that celebrates your traditional food or showcases the best version of your traditional food. Bring that out on the table. Share with your mates. Let's remember that we've had a really tough year. The last couple of months have been absolutely difficult and nightmare, honestly. And this is the perfect time to step back and reflect on the fact that we're still here and we're still united as a nation in fighting COVID-19, but as people as well, right?
Yes, yes, 100%.
It's been so fantastic. We're going to eat, myself and, of course, Biggie and the crew over here. But we leave you with this message from Biggie to all South Africans today on Heritage Day. What do you want to say to them?
I'd say always remember where you come from. Keep in mind where you're going. And don't lose control of yourself. And remember who you are, the best version of yourself, is what you portray to others. And that's always a ray of sunshine to others.
Come on, come on. Well, we're going to eat. Thank you very much for joining us here in Johannesburg. But of course, I'll be back in studio on Monday. I'll see if I can save some of this goodness in a bit of a scuffing for Kuhle and Kat over there. But it's been so beautiful. And we'll see you guys just after this. Happy eating, everybody.